So one very popular approach would be to combine the magnetic disks with flash. The magnetic disk is very cheap per gigabyte compared to flash. We know how to build huge capacity magnetic disks in a relatively small package, but it's very power hungry. It spins and consumes power even when not accessing data, and it's very slow because it has to mechanically move things around in order to access data. And another disadvantage of magnetic disks is that they're sensitive to impact, like if they fall down and hit the ground, while they're spinning, because their heads are then likely to scratch the surface of the disk and permanently damage the whole track, possibly, and maybe the head itself. Flash, on the other hand, is fast, power efficient, and has no moving parts, so if it falls down, it might get damaged, but it's very unlikely. So the idea is to have both of them, and use the flash effectively as a cache for the disk. That way most of the data is on the disk, but the data we are frequently accessing is on the flash, where it's fast, it can be accessed without moving parts, and it can be accessed very efficiently. Now, of course, the disk would still be spinning if we occasionally access it, but if we have enough flash to access data in it for even minutes at a time, we can actually power down the disk and spin it down and only really access it once we have a flash miss. And because both of these can keep their data without power, if we turn off power suddenly, the data in the flash will still survive, and so will the data on the disk. Unlike, for example, if we use a magnetic disk with a DRAM cache to keep the most recently accessed data.